guys.
But they saw how things changed. I know because my mother worked at the Pentagon and rejected the draft call 5 years in advance for the Joint Chiefs of Staff. And in April 1963, Kennedy, on his orders, changed the rejection. Texas for the first time in a 30-year career at the Pentagon for a full withdrawal of American troops from Vietnam by the end of 1964. And when my mother retired, I said, when did they escalate in Vietnam? And she said, late November. I said, the last week? She said, the Monday following the assassination. She said that she was told by the Joint Chiefs that morning, coming in to work, to project a 10-year war with 57,000 American dead. Did that ring any bells for you? That's Vietnam. And they knew where they were going. She was so shocked, she took it up to the Joint Chiefs. She said she'd never done that before and said, these figures can't be right. And they told her those are the figures that she'd use them and she'd put them in her projections. I used to tease her that that was the first civilian protest of the war in Vietnam. And we did what we could to stop that war, but the whole country and its direction changed since then. And we've been in permanent war since then, and it's ruined our economy, and it's also ruined our democratic traditions. And as long as we live in denial and keep up this lie, we're not going to be able to get back to real democracy in this country. And then in 1965, black leadership began to be assassinated, like Malcolm X. And in 68, Martin Luther King. And Robert Kennedy, who tried to stand in for his brother and end the war in Vietnam, was murdered. And hundreds of political murders followed those of political activists and others. If you do your history, and I know it's not a popular topic nowadays, and go back to the Weimar Republic in Germany from the years 1928 to 1932, you will find that there was a series of 400 political murders that the Weimar police could not solve. And they involved the musicians, and the activists, and the labor leaders, and the dissenters, and the academicians who would have stood up to the rise of fascism, they were wiped out. And much of the activism in the 60s was wiped out through the COINTELPRO program to silence dissent in this country, just in the same way that they want to silence our dissent next year. But we'll be visible here in some way. And we hold an annual conference every year with the best new evidence that's coming out. We're the ones that got the JFK records loose. 6.5 million pages, one of the largest releases of classified documents in U.S. history. And they tell the real story. They back up Jim Garrison and the early critics. And they changed the history of the Cuban Missile Crisis and the Bay of Pigs and retold the Kennedy assassination and also his administration's history. And so it's possible to reclaim our history if we want it. It's currently owned by a national security state. But when you don't own your own history, you are a conquered people. That's the first thing a conqueror does, is take your history away from you. And they've been stealing it since 1947 from the American people. It's time that we take it back. It's time that we have a real democracy in this country. And it's time that we stop lying. And we'll be right across there at the Hotel Lawrence. I have a flyer here with the schedule if you'd like to come. We've got 10 great speakers, maybe some more. We're going to be talking about 10 points of agreement of what we know now, 50 years in for sure, about these assassinations and get something on paper that we can put out to the public coming into the 50th. But, you know, if we have to go down to the Trinity River plain, like some of the assassins did that day, and crawl back up through the sewer system and pop out the manhole cover, maybe that's how we'll get to the knoll on the 50th. If we have to go up there and hang a banner from the top of the thing, if we have to have an Occupy, or if we all have to wear a t-shirt that says, "Who killed Kennedy?" We will be visible to you that day. We will not abdicate this position. You know, we'll come out and we'll speak truth to power.
Bravo. Bravo.
Somewhere along in the 90s, the word theory became joined at the hip to the word conspiracy. As if there's no such thing as a conspiracy that isn't a theory. Well, I often say, you can call me a conspiracy theorist if you call everybody else a coincidence theorist. Either we're all theorists or we're not. But we don't do conspiracy theory, but we do conspiracy fact, conspiracy history, conspiracy forensics, ballistics, medical evidence. We have some of the best experts in the country are part of our organization. Our first president was the former president of the American Academy of Forensic Sciences. Dr. Herbert McDonald, who developed the Balliscan macrograph to test bullets by turning them, who's found that Robert Kennedy's bullets in his body didn't match Ciaran's gun. He was on our advisory board. You know, we have academicians and authors and